Thanks, viewer, for coming with me to Rome to view some of the remaining Roman ruins. My trip in 1975 as a high school teacher involved taking 13 students for a two-week tour of Rome, Florence, and Pompeii. We spent 2 or 3 days in Rome and were really impressed by the remaining sculptures, buildings, and the amount of Roman ruins that had been preserved. It was a long trip to Rome. We had to fly from Sault Ste. Marie, Ontario to Toronto, Ontario, and then take another flight from Toronto, Ontario to Italy, landing at the central airport, Fiumicino, in Rome. Rome is a large and very crowded city, as this aerial photograph shows. This medieval map points out the sites that interested us. They were there even in the medieval times. In the center you can see the forum, the Capitoline Hill. To the upper left is the Vatican, including St. Peter's Basilica. When in Rome, we saw a lot more than the Roman ruins, as this composite photo illustrates. However, this little show is just about the ruins left over by the Roman Empire. We saw lots of reliefs, sculptures, mosaics. Gave us a good idea of Roman life. We had a chance to walk over Roman roads. Probably the highlight and the most famous thing to visit is the Colosseum. Here's a photograph of me at the Colosseum, the compulsory photograph. It's not a lot remaining of the Colosseum, as we found out. The interior of the Colosseum once had a wooden floor, which is now gone. However, you can still see the supports for that floor. Yeah, wandering through the Colosseum does give you a pretty good idea of what it might have been like enjoying bread and circuses 2,000 years ago. History is still being discovered in Rome, with many archaeological digs into old Roman ruins, which are being restored. Here's an archaeological dig into a Roman villa. The Arch of Constantine is a famous landmark, and it was erected in 315 to commemorate Constantine's victory. It's absolutely amazing that the carvings survive in this detail after 2,000 years. I think we've all seen the chariot races in the Ben-Hur film, and this is the site where they occurred. There's not much remaining of the old chariot race course. The Roman Forum, or Roman Marketplace, was located below the Capitoline Hill, and this model demonstrates what it might have looked like in Roman times. Here's a map outlining the various Roman structures that were erected there 2,000 years ago. An early sketch of the Forum. Here's what remains today, and you can wander around the towers and ruins. This panoramic view gives you a really good idea of what it's like to be in the Forum and turn yourself around 360 degrees. Another Forum shop. The Forum in the year of the evening. It's still quite majestic. Our hotel room was located near the Pantheon, pictured here. It's one of the earliest perfectly preserved Roman temples, and it's a joy to explore. These slides illustrate the interior of the Pantheon. They're not very good quality, but they do give you an idea of what remains inside. There's all kinds of information on the significance of the hole in the roof and the angle of the sun and information like that. I appreciate your company, viewer, on this brief excursion to Rome to look at some of the Roman remains. I hope you have a good day.